for this session, we have with us Mr. Jaspal Singh, who is Principal Engineer with Center for Development of Advanced Computing in Mohali. So as you know, CDAC, it's a Government of India enterprise. There are 10 CDAC centers in all over India. So Mr. Jaspal has rich experience in doing projects involving microcontrollers. So he will share with you the fundamentals of microcontroller, and he will also demonstrate you the use of microcontroller, how we can use it in automation. So before tea break, he will be deliberating on the fundamentals. After tea break, we will have demonstration session. So now I request Mr. Jaspal Singh.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Okay. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Good morning. Okay, so very quickly, I am going to talk about microcontrollers. So very quickly, you can tell me what have you read it? Anything about microcontrollers? Are you basically aware of the things? What is your background? All are mechanical people here. Mechanical. And which year in mechanical? You are students or you are already working from here? You're already working somewhere?
No, because
that's a student. Okay. Students of which year?
First year
MTech. Okay. And other centers? They're faculty members. Okay. So there is, we have a lot of variety of people. And the faculty members are all mechanical or some other branches also?
Production.
Primarily production. Okay. Are they listening?
Yes, sir.
Okay, right. So we'll start the presentation. You can put this for hosting. Okay, so we'll talk about microcontrollers, their concepts and applications. And before I take you into the microcontroller area, I would just very quickly like to tell you, as sir has told, CDAC is a Government of India organization, and we are working in primarily in advanced computing, but a part of our expertise comes into electronics also. Embedded systems, you call it, electronics, or there are various names. Some people call it professional electronics, and then you can, depending on, and under Ministry of Communication, we and IT, we work on computers and electronics also. So some of the, just very quickly to tell you that what exactly, why I have been called and why, what is the difference. We have developed one, what is called a supercomputer. Is India's supercomputer, India's highest performing computer has been developed by CDAC, which works at 524 teraflops. There's a unit for measuring that. So it's one of the good computers in the world, although not the best one, but one of the good supercomputers. And we work on various areas, including electronics, right? And electronics, we work on various things. There are 10 different centers. At Mohali, we work on electronics, which we call as professional electronics, and embedded system, right? So we have primarily one is this greenhouse climate controller that we have developed, which you can just see. It controls the. Similarly, we have mHealth, mobile health. We have industrial controllers. We have small things. These are small, very small electronics, which you wear them very small. This stethoscope is something like mouse, software to do some other things, right? And we have ubiquitous computing where you have wireless modes. This is CDAC own mode. CDAC ने अपने बनाए हुए हैं ये modes. जो आप XB वगैरह के लेते हैं, वैसे ही हम खुद बनाए हुए हैं हमने. जो आप market से import करते हैं, वो similar modes हमारे पास अपने हैं, right? So this was the background, and we come to now microcontrollers. Before I talk about microcontrollers, the students here may be interested in like why we are talking about microcontrollers. What is the link between this microcontrollers and your mechanical engineering, right? Normally we understand mechanical engineering as some physical thing which moves, which rotates or gives some energy, power. So that kind of things you are generally concerned with. Whereas in microcontrollers, if there is a microcontroller, you will not be able to see ki wo kya kar raha hai, uska kaam kar raha hai ki nahi kar raha, wo bahar se kuch nahi pata chalega. Jab tak ki uski koi output ko aap check nahi karenge, tab tak kuch nahi pata chalega. So is English better or Hindi better?
Both.
Both? Oh, Karnataka people, yeah. Okay, I'll prefer English only. Right. So in the microcontrollers, you cannot see whether it is operating or not operating unless you check the output or some voltage or some current or some parameter. So there is a big difference in these two, but the microcontrollers can enable your mechanical things, working of the mechanical things. So that's why we are learning about microcontrollers. And we all know most of the mechanical engineers are very much interested in automation, robotics, robot banana, and use it for various purposes. Most of the applications like security, like your road management, transport management, the big mechanical things, your process industry, a lot of robots are there in the all these places. And nowadays with electronics, mechanical things, and the computer, which we call as information technology or ICT or whatever names you give it to, but all these things combined, they have converged. They are being used for similar application. All of them are being used for combined in a combined way they are being used, right? So this is what we are why we are interested in this. So very quickly, before I take you into the because if I start delivering the microcontroller lecture, where what are the ports and what are those things, you'll feel slightly bored, because unless you know the background and all the things, it becomes difficult to grasp them. So it is better to give less of your details of the microcontroller and more of the things around it, right? So I'm talking about this electrical and electronics. So again, you may not be able to appreciate what the microcontrollers are doing unless most of the mechanical people may look at motors as their main things for them. Motors are definitely important for mechanical engineers. Motors enable motion, which is an important part of the mechanical engineering. But there is small difference between electrical motors and various electrical things and electronics. Microcontroller is electronics and motors are electrical, right? Can anybody tell me what is the difference? Electrical or electronics mein kya farak hai? What do you think electrical and electronics, what is the difference between them? Okay, anyway, I'll tell. Electrical, we are talking of energy, power. In electronics, we are talking of signal. Although again, energy and power is of concern, but electronics may, the signal is more important. For example, your AC, for example, you're using the electricity for tube light, fan, various things. Okay. What voltage you are getting? 220, 230, 50 hertz. Right? So 50 hertz means 50 cycles per second. So we are not bothered about 50 hertz, कितने वो है, we are not bothered about those things. More of important in this tubelet and fan is कितने watt का ये bulb है, what is the wattage of this bulb, what is the fan speed or how high speed fan है, low speed है, या what type of fan that way. So we are not the AC wave is of not concern, but if you are talking of electronics, then 50 hertz ki 51 hertz hai, that is more important. So in case of electronics, it is the signal, it is the information that is more important. In electrical, it is the energy, it is the power that is more important. This is the small difference. Then another important thing for you, for everybody, is analog and digital. Most of us normally live in an analog world. Most of us, we live in an analog world. Things are analog. Just like you have seen analog watches, digital watches. Analog watches, the circle rotation is linear. The circle rotation is not in steps, it is continuous. But in digital, it's in steps. If it is a 1 second step, it is 1 second. You cannot go lesser than that. If it is a 0.1 second, to 0.1 second. Whatever. Whatever is the resolution or least count. But if it is a digital, it is between this and this step, there is no difference. But there is only one step, either here or here. Between them, there is nothing. So the machines which are digital, they understand two levels. Normally, when we say binary digital, they understand only two levels. There can be other types of digital also, but normally when we generally talk is binary digital. Binary means two levels. So either it is low or high. So there are only two levels we are talking in digital, commonly talking, low level or high level. Beech mein kya hai? Not defined. Right? But in analog, you can have 0 volts, you can have 1 volt, 2 volt, 3 volt, whatever. Jo bhi aapko beech mein bhi hai, to wo you can tell. Obviously, depending on your instrument. Instrument to hai hai. Agar instrument hi nahi hai, to uske beech mein kya dekhoge. But the point is, analog is a continuous thing, digital is in steps. Right? The digitals, and mostly, there is analog electronics, which old radios, you say, AM, FM, lagta tha, AM. Nowadays we have FM and we have many other things. But no, earlier you used to have AM radio only, which was analog amplitude modulation, which is used to be primarily in the analog way. So it is a continuous thing. But in cases of digital, it can be in steps. So when we are talking of digital, we are talking of zeros and ones. Right? I'll just again speak on that also. Digital means you can have logical thing. Logical means if this is the logic, then this is yes or no. Yes and no. That is logical. Sequential means stepwise. First step, second step. So step mein chalta. And all these things combined, we have embedded systems. Right? So I hope you are understanding. You are in line with what I am speaking. Hello, all the centers, is that okay? Hello?
Yes, sir. We are from Parampur. We are able to listen.
Right, right. So, now embedded systems, we just now quickly, I showed you some background of electronics where we talked of digital electronics, analog electronics, and sequential things and binary logical things, right? So all these things, when we put together in some circuits, we call it as embedded system. Now, embedded system means a system which has embedded intelligence, which may have some sensors from the output to receive some output from the physical world, maybe some temperature, light, or something else, rotation, motion, linear motion, that kind of things. Those things are converted into analog, from those analog to into digital, and then processed, and then based on some decision, we do the some actuation, which means, for example, now let me link with your mechanical thing. Right? Suppose you have a system. Let us say you have this system, simple system fan. The fan is a simple motor, and you being a mechanical person, you want to analyze something of it, and you want to say if the speed exceeds this level, tell me this thing. If the speed is less than this, give some other signal. The machine should automatically speak something. Let us say you have this idea ki agar speed is more than this, let us say grow the green bulb. If speed is less than this, glow the red bulb. Let us say very simple thing. Now it is linked with your mechanical. Now how the electronics and automation or embedded system can fit into this and do this work for you, right? This work can be done by putting some kind of sensor which senses the speed. A sensor which senses the speed, there are various types of sensor which can sense the rotational motion. Tachometer is one. Recorders and things are there. More different things have come. You can simply have some kind of device like you have in recorders where the cutting of light is used to record. For even in cases of your car, you have some kind of wire which runs and gives you the output in a digital way. You have nowadays you have a digital meters, right? So similarly, you can have some kind of sensor which senses the speed, right? There are optical sensors also which give the light, right? Which give the light, and based on the light, they will sense the speed of the fan automatically, right? So suppose you have that sensor which measures the some speed, then that speed is to be converted into some value, right? Suppose you have said that if it is greater than 50 rpm, give me this green. Now that 50 rpm, somebody has to say 50. Abhi speed kitni hai? There may be some sensor. The sensor will give some output. The output will be converted into some value, which is 50, 51, 57, or 40, whatever. Theek hai? So that value is to be converted into some digital, right? So this digital value will be compared with what you have already programmed or you have asked. You may have asked ki 40 se jyada hoga to green, or whatever, 50 se jyada hoga to green. So the processor, the controller, which in this particular case I have shown as CPU. CPU stands for Central Processing Unit. So if that that CPU will decide whether the value exceeds your value or not. You have given 40, it will compare with 40. If your input value sensor is giving some 45, it will say 45 aa raha hai. So therefore, it will give a green LED will glow. Right? So although it appears very simple, but it is a complex system can be mapped in this way. Right? So there can be sensors, some conversion, some processing unit, again analog conversion, and then actuator. Right? All this can put together will make an automated system. And the heart of this thing, jiski main cheez hai, the main thing in this is CPU, and that is where the microcontrollers are coming in. Theek hai? So all these things, why I told all these things is because it is the microcontroller which finally will decide what to do, right? So microcontroller is something, is an electronic device, is a miniature semiconductor IC, is a circuit. ठीक है? अगर उसको exact definition हम बोलनी हो तो ये है, if we have to say the exact definition, it is a miniature semiconductor IC, integrated circuit with built-in digital processors. This may be some memory and there may be some other peripherals also. Like you see this diagram, in this diagram, we have CPU, we have analog to digital conversion and digital to analog conversion on the other side, right? And obviously, there may be software, maybe here, which requires some memory and some memory interface, right? In a computer, the CPU is a processor which may have a separate memory, separate conversion unit, separate serial port, separate this thing, all the circuitry may be different. But in case you want to shrink it to small, agar aap usne aapne chota banana hai usko, sari circuitry badi hai, usko choti karni hai, to sari ek IC mein dalenge, to jab wo ek IC mein dalte hai, to we call it as microcontroller. The microcontroller is an example of a IC which converges a lot of these things. ठीक है, उसके अंदर एक CPU भी है, there is a memory also, there is input output system also, there is input output ports we call, it is some mechanism to receive the inputs and give the outputs, and bus means a group of wires, group of connection, right? So you give some input, some things will happen and you will get the output. This is what a microcontroller is. And based on microcontroller, based on this simple thing that you give some input, some things will happen in the microcontroller, you'll get some output. The idea is simple, this, but based on this simple thing, you can do a lot of things. And these are the examples of what you can do with a microcontroller based thing, right? All these things are microcontroller based. You have some microcontroller in each of these things. Most common simple things is the mobile phone nowadays. There's a microcontroller or a processor is one and the same thing. I'll just talk about that also. A small difference is there, right? So all various systems, you whatever electronic item you think, there is either microcontroller or microprocessor in that system. Computers have it. Even nowadays, your washing machine, which is more of a mechanical thing. Washing machine mein bahut sara mechanical hi hai. But still, nowadays you get washing machine which is having electronic microcontroller in it. Aapne dekhe honge, new washing machines have fuzzy video con nikalta fuzzy thing. Some other company will come out with some other version. Some automated, some intelligent washing machine. So all those systems are based on actually microcontroller. So all these examples are systems, are examples of your mechatronic system where mechanical thing as well as some electrical, electronic things are integrated, right? Anybody who wants to say, answer anything to him? Embedded system and microcontroller mein kuch farak hai? Any center wants to speak anything? There's a question here. What is the difference between a microcontroller and embedded system? Anybody want like to say anything? Everybody is busy in their own thing now. Okay, fine, no problems. Answer has also come. Embedded system is a system. It consists of many things, whereas microcontroller is one small part. Microcontroller is a part which is very important. Sabse jyada main to wahi hai, but it's a part. Again, it's a part. So embedded system is a system which has the microcontroller, which has some sensors, which may have some more things, may have some mechanical thing also. Embedded system is a system which has embedded microcontroller. इसलिए उसको एम्बेडेड सिस्टम बोलते हैं, बिकॉज उसमें एम्बेडेड है इंटेलिजेंस, एंड माइक्रोकंट्रोलर इज द सिंबल ऑफ इंटेलिजेंस. The symbol matlab it holds the intelligence. It is something that enables the intelligence. जिसकी वजह से वो intelligence काम करती है, right? And just to take you more into your interest area, because all the centers I've seen, remote centers are having some other time pass. The car is one of the most mechanical, people love it. You know, the car is a purely automobile thing and a purely mechanical thing. But nowadays, cars have got microcontrollers. Most of the modern cars are having microcontrollers. Can you just tell me what are the microcontrollers used in this for?
Most of the cars nowadays.
Can anybody else also speak?
Acceleration,
it's
also
the
wiper system.
Wiper system.
Sensors,
okay. Anybody else? Any remote center would like to say what are the microcontrollers used for in a car? ऐसे नहीं बोलेंगे ये यहाँ पे लिखा हुआ है. What is this? बनूड. बनूड एक. हेलो ज्ञान ज्योति. हेलो
हेलो सर, कैन यू हियर मी?
या
सर, वी हैव.
Yeah.
So we have the systems of embedded, like all the automation parts, like we have the back cameras, then we have the automation systems, we have the sensors for temperatures, AC coolants. These are all comes under the embedded system parts, which are used in the car, automobiles.
Yeah, good. There is some small difference I would like to point out, but let me hear other centers also. Yes, Enathur. Enathur, क्या कहते हैं इसको? What is the name? Yes, Tamil Nadu Center. How do you think a microcontroller is used in a car? Is it useful for car? Any thoughts? Okay. Thank you. No problems. Gate Odisha. Hello.
Yes, sir.
How do you think microcontrollers can be used in a car?
To see the how the performance of a car in a dashboard. The microcontroller can operate the signals for the measuring the various temperature or power consumption or fuel consumption.
Right. That's good. That's a better answer. Hoshiarpur. Hello. Sir, I'm just trying to make you interested in this. How do you think a microcontroller can be used in a car? Car mein kya karta hai microcontroller? Silly. Sorry, we are not able to hear you. No problems. Okay. You see, Gyan Jyoti has given good answer, and Odisha has also given a good answer. The students here have also given a good answer. But small things I would like to point out. One, there is a wiper controller. There is an indicator for your speed. There is a let us say cameras for the front or the back or whatever sensors, distance sensors. So all those things are electronics which may or may not have a microcontroller. For example, your wiper can have a simple sensor. If there is a rain, automatically start the wiper. There may or may not be a microcontroller, because the intelligence may not be so much of intelligence may not be required. It may be simple one step. More than this, start wiper, no rain, stop. Right? It can be just this thing which can be done without microcontroller also. But there are certain things like control of your ignition, which is nowadays done with the help of microcontroller. There is a engine control system, ECS, which is nowadays used in modern cars. Na? अगर आप आजकल की कार देखें और पुरानी कार्स देखें, जब तक आपका इंजन स्टार्ट नहीं होगा, रन नहीं करेगा, तब तक आपकी जो है वेरियस सिस्टम्स काम नहीं करते. फॉर एग्जांपल, योर ब्रेक विल नॉट वर्क, योर फ्यूल इंजेक्शन जो है वो डज नॉट स्टार्ट टिल दैट टाइम. वेयर एज इन ओल्डर कार्स देयर वाज अ डिफरेंट सिस्टम. एज सून एज मैकेनिकली इट इज फ्री, इट विल स्टार्ट. हियर the engine control unit is there, which controls not only the triggering of firing of that valve, but all the ignition, but it controls the valve also. You very latest system, you have a variable valve technology, variable VVT. What is that? Variable transmission. That is based on transmission. Okay, sorry. There is another system which I heard was that I do not remember the exact name for that. Is that you can vary the various parameters of the engine automatically by sensing. You don't need to do your mechanical things. Do not do it. Earlier you used to have a mechanical thing. Wo ek spark plug hai, ignition hai, those kind of things would do it. Nowadays those things are done by electronic unit. So more than that, more than your simple wiper control or a camera or that kind of things, there are things which are being controlled by electronics, by a microcontroller inside them, right? So agar aap modern car ki service dekhen, the people, most of the old people will not be able to do the service of a modern car because they say simply ki ye to sir, it is some company based thing. The company people can only do it, I cannot do it. Because there is some electronics control in it which people cannot handle, right? Which is not controlled, which is not seen. You cannot see ki aise ho raha ki nahi ho raha. It is only the electronics which will be able to tell you, right? So that is what I wanted to point out to you. It is where it is entering into your mechanical area. I can talk about the microcontroller for I take one full week class for microcontroller, but if I start speaking about microcontroller for full day, there is no use. So unless I make it more interesting to you by linking it with your things, right? So that is why I gave you all these things. Now I just let me come to the exact topic, exact hardcore items that you may enjoy or you may not enjoy. So there is a small difference between microprocessor and a microcontroller. Microprocessor is a small miniature IC which it does the processing, right? Information processing. It may not have some memory, it may not have any memory, it may not have various ports, input output ports, right? So a CPU receives the data from various other things and gives you some output, right? So for most computers we use a processor, like your Intel, jaise hamare what are the modern processors being used in computer? Intel i7, i-core 2, this thing, that thing. So those are the processors which are meant for processing. What processing? What? Processing the information. So you give hundreds of millions of data to this processor, it will process you. It will process the data, right? But it is not good at giving the outputs in terms of physical things, in terms of input output ports. It is more useful for processing. Image processing karni hai, you can do very good in a processor, right? Whereas a microcontroller is again an IC, but it has a memory, a CPU, a timer, all the things built into it. Uske andar hi hai sara kuch ghusa diya. राइट सो व्हाट इट डज देखिए अगर आपने बहुत ज्यादा मेमोरी चाहिए इसमें व्हाट इज द साइज ऑफ द मेमोरी इन ए कंप्यूटर 500 GB हार्ड डिस्क 4 GB रैम राइट सो इट इज इन द टर्म्स ऑफ जीबीज जीबी मींस गीगाबाइट्स राइट गीगा मींस 10^6 राइट सो इफ यू हैव टू यूज बिग मेमोरीज बिग प्रोसेसर बिग थिंग्स देन द कंप्यूटर इज द थिंग सारी चीजों को अलग अलग कर दिया मेमोरी के लिए स्पेशल चीज अलग इट गोज सेपरेट टाइमर अलग ये अलग वो अलग राइट सो दैट इज द वे बट अगर आपने छोटी सी चीज करनी है तो यू वॉन्ट टू मेक इट स्मॉल सो वॉट यू डू छोटा सा मेमोरी ले लो छोटा टाइमर छोटा ये छोटा वो ऑल द स्मॉल स्मॉल थिंग्स यू पुट इन टू वन थिंग एंड दैट्स वॉट वी कॉल एज माइक्रो कंट्रोलर राइट दिस इज द स्मॉल डिफरेंस बिटवीन द थिंग्स राइट सो इट इज अ सिंगल चिप विच हैज ऑल दीज थिंग्स इन बिल्ट इन टू इट ठीक है ये स्मॉल डिफरेंस इफ यू कैन रिमेंबर इफ यू कैन मेक यूज ऑफ दिस थिंग इन योर मैकेट्रॉनिक्स आई थिंक 80% ऑफ द पर्पस ऑफ दिस इज सॉल्व कि माइक्रो कंट्रोलर कब और क्यों यूज करना है यू लर्न सारी पोथी पढ़ लो माइक्रो कंट्रोलर की इफ यू डोंट नो कब और क्यों यूज करना है व्हाट इज द फन ऑफ दैट राइट सो यू मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड दीज स्मॉल थिंग्स दैट इज व्हाई आई एम गिविंग मोर टाइम ऑन दीज थिंग्स आपको बार बार ये चीजें बोल रहा हूं राइट सो माइक्रो प्रोसेसर माइक्रो कंट्रोलर कब आपने कंप्यूटर यूज करना है कब आपने एम्बेडेड सिस्टम यूज करना है माइक्रो कंट्रोलर वाला राइट दैट यू मस्ट बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड अगेन द सेम थिंग बट लेट अस स्किप दिस सो कमिंग बैक टू दिस माइक्रो कंट्रोलर एज आई टोल्ड अर्लियर इट हैज बस बस इज अ सिंपल इंटरकनेक्शंस नथिंग A CPU, which is a which primarily consists of what we call as arithmetic and logic unit, and a memory, and input output. Right? The input outputs can be serial or digital. Serial means output coming one by one, ek ek karke. Parallel means all the outputs are coming in same time. Memory can be of two types. ROM or RAM. RAM is random access memory and ROM is read-only memory, right? So which is used to store the program or the data. RAM is used to store the temporary information, right? For example, aapko bolte hai na ki ye multiply 5721 by 9.5. So aap usko temporarily kahin pe likhoge. इसमें इतना कैरी हो गया इसका मल्टीप्लाई वो दैट टेम्पररी थिंग्स आर डन इन रैम राइट सो दीज आर द कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ ए माइक्रो कंट्रोलर स्लाइटली मोर डिटेल्ड देन द प्रीवियस वन मेमोरी वी सेड देन द सीपीयू वी हैव अ इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग कॉल्ड एएलयू एएलयू स्टैंड्स फॉर अच्छा अरिथमेटिक एंड लॉजिक यूनिट यू ऑलरेडी नो यू स्टडीड द सब्जेक्ट वन कोर्स ओके एनीवे एएलयू स्टैंड्स फॉर अरिथमेटिक एंड लॉजिक यूनिट सो इट इज अ सर्किट इनसाइड द माइक्रो कंट्रोलर इट इज अ सर्किट व्हिच इज डिजाइंड टू एनेबल अरिथमेटिक प्रोसेसेस प्राइमरीली एडिशन अरिथमेटिक में प्राइमरी सबसे मेन सबसे सिंपल चीज है एडिशन एंड कंपैरिजन बस उनके डिजाइन सर्किट इज डिजाइन इन सच ए वे कि 1+1 आएगा तो वो 10 शो करेगा 1 इज 10 बट डिजिटल में आई एम टॉकिंग 1+1 इज इक्वल 2 सो इन डिजिटल 1+1 इज इक्वल टू 10 ओके सो दैट सर्किट इज डिजाइंड इन दैट वे देन यू हैव बस बस स्टैंड्स फॉर ग्रुप ऑफ वायर्स which can generally be 8. 8 हम इसलिए कहते हैं हमने डिजिटल जो सिस्टम्स जो भी बनाए हैं बाई कन्वेंशन बाई कॉमन आइडिया वी हैव गिवन 8-bit डिजिटल राइट नाउ व्हाट डज 8-bit डिजिटल मीन्स एनीबडी 8 बिट्स मीन any signal is converted into digital value which has 8 digits, that is called as 8 bits. बोर्ड पे तो नहीं कर सकते
Let us say there is a small some signal. This with your analog, this thing. Let us say this is 0, this is 1, this is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Some values are just randomly given. Now this. Is an analog system. In analog way, between this and this, you can easily say 0.5 over, 0.6 over, something. Right? But when we are talking about digital, we either say this value or this value. Right? The simplest way you can describe this in a binary way is by giving this is 0, this is 1, either 0 or 1. Okay? Now, you have to say this is 0, bhi dikhana, 1, bhi dikhana, 2. Bhi dikhana. So, 0, 1 se nahi dikhega. 1, 0 is. 2, तीन वैल्यू से 1-1 पे 3 आ गया. इसको दिखाने के लिए मतलब तीन अगर मेरे पास सो व्हाट आई मीन टू से इज दैट लुक हियर इफ आई हैव ओनली टू बिट्स मेरे पास दो ही चीजें हैं बताने के लिए कि सिग्नल कितना है तो मैं क्या बता सकता हूं आई कैन टेल आइदर 0 आई कैन टेल 1 आई कैन टेल 2 आई कैन टेल 3 बट अगर 4 मैंने दिखाना है इन 2 बिट्स आई एम नॉट एबल टू शो मेरे को आई विल नॉट बी एबल टू शो 4 के लिए कुछ और मेरे को लगाना पड़ेगा मतलब मेरा इलेक्ट्रॉनिक सर्किट जो है अगर इफ इट इज हैविंग ओनली 2 थिंग्स 2 डिस्प्लेस एंड बीइंग अ डिजिटल यू कैन आइदर गिव 0 और 1 इसके अलावा कुछ नहीं दे सकते यू कैन नॉट गिव एनीथिंग एल्स So 00, 01, 10, 11 are the four symbols I can give using 2. Right? So like that, 8 bit means 8 symbols. 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 8 bar 0 likhne se. This stands for 0 and 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. This is the highest number I can show in 8 bit. Right? This is what it means. So 256 is the highest one. Right? So if could you get the idea? 8 bit means we have assumed the world, the physical world, to be consisting of only 256 steps. Right? अगर हमारे पास जो भी एनालॉग वर्ड को हमने मैप करना है वट एवर वी वॉन्ट टू मैप फ्रॉम द एनालॉग वर्ड टू द डिजिटल वर्ल्ड एंड इफ वी अज्यूम ओनली 256 लेवल्स 256 चीजें ही हो सकती है उससे ज्यादा नहीं हो सकती देन दैट मीन्स आई कैन डू विद 8 बिट्स राइट सो लाइक दैट अगर जितना इफ यू वॉन्ट मोर प्रिसाइज थिंग्स यू वॉन्ट मोर नंबर ऑफ वायर्स मोर नंबर ऑफ बिट्स So that is what it means by 8-bit. Most of the digital world microcontrollers, simplest, are 8-bit. The lowest value generally we talk of 8-bit. So, agar aapko, if I say now you have to tell me the speed of the fan in an 8-bit system. How many different speeds can you tell? 256. So you can give 256 different values of the speed इन 8 बिट माइक्रो कंट्रोलर अगर आपको 256 से भी ज्यादा वैल्यूज चाहिए तो देन यू विल हैव टू गो फॉर मोर राइट और यू हैव टू डू सम ट्रिक बाय 8 बिट को भी उससे हायर में भी कर सकते हैं बट वो उसे ट्रिक्स लगानी पड़ती हैं व्हिच इज अ कॉम्प्लेक्स थिंग पहले ये दिखा दो फिर वो दिखा दो फिर अननेसेसरी प्रॉब्लम्स राइट सो दिस इज व्हाट वी मीन बाय 8 बिट देन इनपुट आउटपुट पोर्ट्स मीन receiving input data from some sensor, output to some relay, some motor, something, that kind of thing. Then serial communication means serially one by one
you have to do some communication. Timer unit, watchdog timer is something which keeps on working continuously. Analog to digital converter is also there in the microcontroller. Right? Most of the microcontrollers nowadays have ADC inbuilt. उससे ज्यादा भी हो गया आजकल, right? So let us come to this diagram, which gives you a very good indication of how a microcontroller works, right? Let me just explain this. You'll love it. This is given in a way mechanical people would like to be enjoy. They'll enjoy. So, Odisha and Tamil Nadu, are you in line? Yeah, okay. So, just look at this slide, working on microcontroller. This slide has shows the different components of the microcontroller in a way which is very easy to understand for us, right? It shows some watchdog timer here, oscillator and oscillator divider, some timers here, some special function registers here, SFR we call them. RAM memory stands for random access memory. Analog to digital converter, which receives the analog inputs from here and gives the digital output to this unit, control unit, which is control and logic unit. Then you have an accumulator, which keeps on accumulating something. I'll just talk about that. Arithmetic and logic unit, decoder, instruction decoder primarily, some program memory, program counter, EPROM, plus some power supply, right? So now when you give power supply, external power supply to the microcontroller, the things start moving. And you need to connect what is this called as crystal oscillator. This is the external component which is required to start the working of a microcontroller. So there are two things that are required for the working of a microcontroller to start. External two things required. One is this crystal oscillator and the second is the power supply. So as soon as you give the power supply and the crystal, there starts happening some oscillator starts working, right? Oscillator is nothing but it oscillates between tick, 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 something like you can say timer start ho gaya, ghadi chalne lag gayi, the work has started, right? So when the oscillator starts, oscillator divided by n, there is some internal number which machine will automatically do. You can simply say let it be 1, no problem. So when the oscillator starts, let us say there is some beat of the drum. To show as example, every oscillation, every beat, there will be beat, tuck, tuck, tuck. Something will start happening in the microcontroller. To show you in an analog mechanical example, let us say there is a beat. At every one oscillation, there is a beat, tuck, tuck, tuck. Things start moving, right? And at every beat, the things move. First thing that moves is the program counter will start at this location. It, whatever location, zero location is defined, it will start at that location, right? Let us say this is the location or whatever. So one plunger will come in. At the one beat, the plunger will plunge in. And what will happen, whatever is there in the memory, this particular thing, rod, camshaft, or whatever you want to call it. What is it, camshaft? Plunger, oh, I call it plunger, I don't know what is the exact name. So this thing will come and it will push whatever is the instruction here into this instruction decoder. Okay? At a beat, this plunger here will plunge in and push something from the memory into the instruction decoder. The instruction decoder will receive something. Uske andar kuch aa gaya. There is something that comes in. Right? and when it comes in, it decodes it. Whatever is the instruction here in this memory, it will be decoded. The decoder will tell the, for example, let us say it has some work to do from memory, receive something from this. So it will receive something from this, right? Suppose then, and the next beat comes, right? So right now what has happened? Memory se ek cheez utha li hai. Based on the instruction, based on the program memory, one thing has been picked up by the logic unit, right? Control and logic unit has picked up some information. Let us say it is a 0-1, right? Then the next beat comes. Ek beat mein ek hi cheez hai, controller ke andar 0-1 aa gaya. Next beat mein this thing will move. There. The cursor at the next beat, this thing will move down by one count, and the plunger will come here. So what will happen? The plunger will push the next thing. Pehle is wali memory ko bheja tha, now it will push the next thing because the plunger has moved in. This has gone up, right? So next byte will go into this. ठीक है, सो नेक्स्ट थिंग डिकोडिंग इज लेट अस ए इंक्रीमेंट. सो पहले मेमोरी में आया 0-1, नाउ द नेक्स्ट थिंग इज रिटन इन द मेमोरी इज द इंक्रीमेंट, इंक्रीज इट. सो व्हाट विल दिस डू? इंस्ट्रक्शन डिकोडर विल कम टू नो दैट आई हैव टू इंक्रीज इट. सो इट विल आस्क द एएलयू कि एक्यूमुलेटर में सेंड द इंक्रीज्ड थिंग इन टू एक्यूमुलेटर. So the accumulator will receive, earlier it was having 1, now it will receive 2, right? So again a beat will happen. Again on the next beat, the next program will come. The next program, suppose it says, whatever is there in the memory, give it to the out, right? So the output port will receive the 2. So 1 aaya tha, usko increase karke 2 de diya. Suppose it is very simple thing. So all the things work in this way. At every beat, all the things work. All the things work. At the one beat, this thing has come in. Decoder will decode the information. Isko bola tha, ye memory idhar bhej de. It has sent the data here. Timer will, suppose you have asked the timer to keep on recording the time, so it will keep on recording the time. Suppose you have asked the watchdog timer to tell me कि भी वॉचडॉग, इट्स अ वॉचडॉग, यू हैव सपोज यू हैव आस्क्ड इट कि मेरे को एक घंटा के बाद मेरे को जगा देना, तो आफ्टर वन आवर इट विल, फॉर वन आवर इट विल कीप ऑन टेकिंग, आफ्टर दैट वन आवर इट विल गिव यू द सिग्नल कि गेट अप, राइट? सो ऑल द थिंग्स विल वर्क डिपेंडिंग ऑन योर प्रोग्राम, वट एवर यू प्रोग्राम. सो वट एवर यू प्रोग्राम दैट विल हैपन इन स्टेप्स, एट एवरी बीट वन स्टेप विल हैपन, next step karte karte it will work your all the things, right? And the good thing is that this beats happen in the terms of megahertz. Har second mein thousands of times this thing is happening. So therefore, although it is happening in one beat, aapne, you want to add 1 plus 1, it will take 3 beats. One पहले वन आएगा, इट विल इंक्रीज, फिर वन आएगा, फिर उसको इंक्रीज करेगा, फिर अगले स्टेप में वो नीचे देगा आउटपुट में. बट 3 or 4 बीट्स इट विल टेक. बट बिकॉज दीज थिंग्स आर हैपनिंग इन सो फास्ट, थाउजेंड्स ऑफ बीट्स पर सेकेंड, सो फॉर यू इट विल बी डी आर आउट आ गया, राइट? सो सिमिलरली फॉर कैलकुलेटर, इट मे टेक हंड्रेड्स ऑफ साइकिल्स फॉर वन बिग कैलकुलेशन दैट यू मे गिव, बट फॉर यू इट इज जस्ट ए not even a second, because the calculator is working in megahertz, thousands or maybe lakhs of times beats per second, right? When I am talking of megahertz, that means lakhs of beats per second. So lakh of operation are doing in 1 second. So therefore it is very fast, right? Although everything is happening in steps, so it is these steps you have to understand. for doing anything into your mechatronic thing, you have to understand the steps. This step, then this step, then this step. If you understand the steps, then you can implement the program. Right? That is the idea. What is the time? Are we? 11:15 we are supposed to break, yeah? Yeah? Or 11:30? Okay. Okay. So this is how the microcontroller works, and all these things happen in electronics way. There is no plunger, there is nothing. It is only that at every beat, the next instruction will be passed on to the decoder. And beat is just to show you as a mechanical example, but it is a tick of the oscillator, which can only be seen on an oscilloscope, and otherwise you cannot just see it, you cannot hear it, you cannot happen. But it just is not there. Right, it happens millions of times per second. Right, so how? So this is the program. I said that you can give some kind of program in this program memory, and it will do that in steps. Right. So how do we do this? This is done by first writing a program. Steps mein aap us program ko likhte hain, then you give it to the PC. Matlab PC ke upar hi likhenge obviously. और तो कहां लिखेंगे प्रोग्राम? यू राइट द प्रोग्राम ऑन द पीसी एंड देर इज अ स्मॉल सर्किट विच इज कॉल्ड प्रोग्रामर. दिस सर्किट विल पास इट ऑन टू द माइक्रो कंट्रोलर बिकॉज द लैंग्वेज ऑफ दिस, जो आपको लैंग्वेज समझ आती है और जो माइक्रो कंट्रोलर को लैंग्वेज समझ आती है, इट्स डिफरेंट. सो वी नीड ऑल दीज थिंग्स इन बिटवीन. एंड नॉर्मली दिस इज शोन एज ए प्रोग्रामर, दिस इज ए माइक्रोकंट्रोलर. ठीक है, ये माइक्रोकंट्रोलर है छोटा सा आईसी, ये प्रोग्रामर है, ये पीसी को कनेक्टेड है इधर. ठीक है, कंप्यूटर से आ रही है ये वायर, ये प्रोग्रामर है और ये वायर इसको कंट्रोलर को हमने दी हुई है. राइट, सो यू फीड द प्रोग्राम फ्रॉम द कंप्यूटर इन टू दिस एंड देन दिस थिंग, दिस आईसी विल बी फिक्स्ड इन सम सर्किट. सर्किट में लगने के बाद इट विल कीप ऑन डूइंग द थिंग्स वन बाय वन, स्टेप बाय स्टेप वो चलता रहेगा. राइट, सो दीज आर द टाइप्स ऑफ माइक्रो कंट्रोलर्स, और टाइप्स नहीं, आई शुड से एक फिजिकल फॉर्म ऑफ द माइक्रो कंट्रोलर. इट कैन बी अ सिंपल योर डिप डुअल इन लाइन पैकेज, जिस जो नॉर्मली हमने आईसी देखे होते हैं, बट आजकल डिप का काम बहुत कम हो गया, कोई नहीं इसको पूछता. This is SOIC, छोटे हो गए. ये इतना बड़ा कंट्रोलर has now come into small size of these types or even these types. Here the pins are on two sides, here the pins are on all four sides. Right? This we call SOIC, small outline package, and this we call as quad, Q, F, N or various other names are also there. Quad package है ये, चारों साइड में इसके टांगे हैं. Right? So coming to the controller types, you can ek bahut hi simple tarika hai, there is a simple way of telling the types, is that 8 bit, 16 bit, 32 bit. Right, nowadays your processors are coming kitne bit ke hai? 64 processors are 64 bit, but microcontroller abhi 32 bit mein hi most of the kaam chal jata hai. Microcontroller 32 bit is supposed to be a very गुड माइक्रो कंट्रोलर. नॉर्मली 8 बिट यूज होते हैं, थोड़ा सा अच्छा काम करना है 16 बिट, बहुत ही कोई फंडू काम करना है तो 32 बिट. राइट, सो एक एग्जांपल मैंने यहां पे दिया है पिक. पिक इज अ सीरीज ऑफ माइक्रो कंट्रोलर्स, जिसमें कि हमें ये सीरीज शो की हुई है. 8 बिट की सीरीज है, 16 बिट की सीरीज है, 32 बिट की सीरीज है. राइट, एक बीच में उन्होंने डीएसपिक फैमिली एक अलग से स्पेशल लगाया हुआ है, विच इज अ डिजिटल सिग्नल प्रोसेसिंग, वो थोड़ा सा अलग काम के लिए लगा रखा है, बट ठीक है. फॉर यू टू अंडरस्टैंड इज दैट तीन टाइप के, मोस्ट प्राइमरी वे ऑफ टेलिंग माइक्रो कंट्रोलर टाइप्स इज 8 बिट, 16 बिट, 32 बिट. Right, then there are other ways also of telling कि भी उसके अंदर memory कैसी लगी हुई है. There may be microcontrollers without the memory or big memory. एक instruction set के basis पे हम microcontroller के type बताते हैं. RISC and CISC. RISC is reduced instruction and this is compact instruction. Then memory architecture के basis पे है. Harvard architecture है, Von Neumann है, Princeton है और भी काफी सारे हैं. Family के basis पे है, जैसे मैंने अभी आपको PIC की family बताई. ऐसी एक 8051 एक फैमिली है जो काफी सारे कंप्यूटर सॉरी मैन्युफैक्चरर्स बनाते हैं. इंटेल, एटमेल, एसटी माइक्रो, बहुत सारी कंपनीज जो है 8051 सीरीज पे बनाती हैं. सो इफ मोस्ट कॉमन माइक्रो कंट्रोलर जो आप देखेंगे इज द 8051, राइट. And applications, you know, there are endless applications. This is a simple small robo which is has a but it works on the floor pe chalta rehta hai apne aap se distance dekh ke. It has a microcontroller. Car mein bahut sare microcontroller ke processes possibilities hain. Industry mein hain, consumer mein aapne dekh liya. Then healthcare mein hain, appliances, automobile industry. इंडस्ट्री में अपने रोबोस, वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ रोबोस यू ऑलरेडी मस्ट बी अवेयर, जो पिक एंड प्लेस इज सिंपलेस्ट एग्जांपल. बट उसमें अगर आपने इंटेलिजेंस देनी है तो माइक्रो कंट्रोलर्स विल कम इनटू द पिक्चर. जितनी इंटेलिजेंस ज्यादा चाहिए उतना है आपको माइक्रो कंट्रोलर के बेस्ड काम ज्यादा लेना पड़ेगा, राइट. एंड बिफोर वी ब्रेक, I just quickly tell you what can be the criteria for choosing a microcontroller. It is simply, सबसे पहले आपको देखना पड़ेगा how fast you want to do some process. अगर speed is important, right? अगर आपकी speed है कि motor की speed इतनी high है and उसकी दो cycle से पहले मैं decision ले लूँ, so then you obviously need a high speed. कि दो second में उसको रोकना है, दो second में उसको ये करना है, some action, then obviously you need a high speed. बट नॉर्मली फॉर मोस्ट ऑफ अवर जो हम स्टूडेंट लाइफ में करते हैं, स्पीड इज इमटीरियल. स्पीड हमें कोई मतलब नहीं है. स्पीड का कोई भी स्पीड हो, मतलब वो हमारे लिए बहुत ही ज्यादा होती है. मिली सेकेंड में काम हो गया, बहुत है, इससे ज्यादा क्या चाहिए. सेकेंड इज स्टूडेंट लाइफ में मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट इज पैकेजिंग, बिकॉज स्टूडेंट में इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू प्रोग्राम सम हाई एंड थिंग्स. तो उसको आपको कैसे वाला पैकेज आपको यूज करना है, दैट इज डिप. सिंपल जो सिंपलेस्ट वाला है ना, वो डिप है. We call as DIP, DIP. वही वाला पैकेज आप लेंगे तो आप उसको आसानी से यूज कर सकते हैं. बाकी कोई ले लेंगे तो आपको पता ही नहीं चलेगा कैसे उसको यूज करें, राइट. इसको प्रोग्रामिंग मुश्किल हो जाएगी, या फिर प्रोग्रामर भी साथ में आपको अलग से लेना पड़ेगा. या आजकल नए नए पैकेजेस और भी आ गए हैं जो कि सारा कुछ इकट्ठा ही सप्लाई कर देते हैं, एंड दे आर चीप ऑल्सो. So packaging again may not be so. Power consumption is also, industry में अगर आप use करते हैं तो power consumption बहुत critical हो जाती है, but वो भी यहाँ पे जरूरी नहीं है. Amount of RAM, ROM, कितनी memory है आपका program, कितना बड़ा है, कितने steps करने हैं आपने, हजारों steps करने हैं. Most of the normal work that we do with a microcontroller, 2-4 हजार steps तो बन ही जाते हैं उसमें, right? So which means kilobyte का data तो कोई बड़ी चीज नहीं है. 1000 steps means 1 kilobyte, right? So kilobyte का कोई चीज जो है ना, kilobyte is considered to be very small program. So RAM, ROM कितनी चाहिए आपको, that depends what type of work you want to do. Another thing is number of IOs, input outputs, which means for example आपने temperature भी sense करना है, humidity भी sense करना है, और ये भी करना है, लोग भी देखने हैं कितने लोग बैठे हैं, उसके basis पे आपने एसी भी चलाना है, फैन भी चलाना है, ट्यूबलाइट भी चलानी है. सो आईओज आपको ज्यादा चाहिए, इनपुट आउटपुट ज्यादा चाहिए. आपने एक ही चीज देखनी है, टेम्परेचर कितना है, एसी ऑन करना है कि बंद करना है, बस. अगर आपने यही स्टेप करने हैं तो स्मॉल वन इनपुट वन आउटपुट माइक्रो कंट्रोलर इज गुड. बट व्हेन यू हैव टू डू मोर नंबर ऑफ थिंग्स, यू वॉन्ट मोर नंबर ऑफ आईओज, राइट. फिर उसमें सीरियल पैरेलल का भी एक इश्यू आता है, वो भी ठीक है. Upgradation, cost and availability. So for us, for a student life, most important thing the availability of tools. कौन सा tool available है, कौन सा microcontroller available है, कितने का पैसे का है, बस यही चीजें से खत्म हो जाती है कहानी. But in industry, these are the last items. इसने जो काम करना है उसके लिए वो करेगा कि नहीं, that is most important, right? So various companies give 8051. अगर आप और details इसके सुनना चाहते हैं तो I have 8051 family पे complete मेरे पास, right? Teach lot of the things also. 8051 के basis पे बहुत details हैं. एंड कितने पोर्ट हैं, कितनी मेमोरी है, क्या उसका प्रोग्राम है, कैसे करना है, कैसे असेंबली करनी है कि दूसरे में करना है, ब्लॉक डायग्राम क्या है, डिटेल्ड ऑल द थिंग्स कैन बी शोन, बट आई डोंट थिंक यू रिक्वायर ऑल दोस थिंग्स नाउ. उनको आपको ठूस ठूस के देने का कोई पर्पस नहीं है, राइट? सो आई थिंक विद दिस आई विल स्टॉप हियर एंड आस्क यू इफ देयर आर एनी क्वेरीज फ्रॉम योर साइड.